underground radio station here, and we say what we feel like saying.
This is Agent X of the Radio First Turner Shows. The following program is brought to you in high definition. Dave Rabbit Audio.
Hey everybody, welcome to the night show. And man, we've got a gangbuster for you tonight. We're going to start out with the first song called Twisted from a band out of Bel Air, Maryland called Out of the Cold. And the hits just keep on coming. Twisted from the band known as Out of the Cold from Bel Air, Maryland. We're talking about Mike Galvatron and Steve. And Galvatron, I'm telling you, brother, I love the name, man. I love the name. It's almost like something out of that Transformers movie. Mike Galvatron and Steve. Anyway, you can find out more about these guys by going to their homepage at myspace.com/ Out of the Cold. And we've got three more great songs that are coming up shortly. Well, let's get to it. We got a great program. But by first, I've got to say, man, what did you think about the Charlie Sheen ABC interview that just recently broadcasted? I got to tell you, you know, I said last show, I like Charlie Sheen as an actor. I think he's really talented or whatever. But I got to be honest. I mean, even for Dave, I thought he was friggin' out there, you know. He may be clean on drugs, but I got news for you. He is absolutely gone berserk. I have not seen this type of behavior since the Mel Gibson episodes. And I tell you what it kind of reminds me of is that he kind of is into the same mode that Jimi Hendrix was, that Janis Joplin was, and several of those high-profile rockers that live that rock style, you know, self indestructible mode mentality, and that's really where Charlie's at. You know, I mean, my God, I mean, I was in astonishment sitting here and listening to what he has to say. I mean, it was like he was on a different plateau than the entire planet. Now, to give you some idea of the popularity that Charlie Sheen has acquired since he started going over the edge, he has 1 million people that have subscribed to his new Twitter account. And he gets on there and just says, well, the world's fucked up, or whatever he wants to say. You know, it makes for some very entertaining tweets. Now, I didn't subscribe to it because I don't give a rat's ass what Charlie Sheen does on a day-to-day basis, you know. But I did note in the AP feed that I'm looking at that all that stuff is going on. And, you know, I don't know. He lost his 2 little boys. My God, he's living with 2 hot chicks, 2 porn stars, you know. And on the interview, they're sitting there saying that they you know, that she loves Charlie. And then the other girl says, I love Charlie. And then we love each other. And I'm thinking, wow, menage a trois heaven, baby puppy. Yeah, 2 chicks and yourself. Let's see. I don't know if I could dig that or not. Yeah, right. Okay, anyway, so the other thing that I think it really kind of strikes a chord with me, and, you know, $30,000 for a night with an assortment of hookers. I mean, my God. First off, I doubt seriously, Dave, I don't care how much Viagra, Levitra, and Cialis I ever had on stock, I don't think I could keep a bunch of string of hookers happy, even if I spent $30,000. That's number one. And number two, $30,000 for hookers? My God. You know, geez. You know, I could live for probably a year and a half on 30 grand, you know, assuming that, of course, I lived off of love and all the rest was just for rent and all this other stuff. Okay, anyway. So enough about Charlie Sheen. Okay. The movie background of the week is called The Time Machine. I was 12 years old when this movie came out, and I saw it. I'll never forget. I saw it in downtown Fort Worth, Texas, because my mom and I, who was a single parent at the time, happened to live in Fort Worth at the time because of a job that she was trying to get. It's an H.G. Wells novel that came out in 1895 that was turned into this movie that came out on August the 17th, 1960. Stars Rod Taylor, Yvette Menu, Alan Young, and Sebastian Cabot. $850,000 was the budget, and made literally millions and millions and millions of dollars on all the other stuff. And what's really interesting is that in the 2002 sequel, they copied a lot of the and of course they went by the H.G. Wells novel, but they copied a lot of the things. Now, you know, special effects wise, obviously the 2002 sequel was superior to the original version, but, you know, I still absolutely love this version here, and that's what's going to be going on in the background. All right, we're going to continue on with music from Out of the Cold. You're going to like this one. It's called Our Place Among. Now I find my